up high, and the dreams that you dreamed of once in a lullaby, somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly. And the dreams that you dreamed of, dreams really do come true. Someday I'll wish upon a star, wake up where the clouds are far behind me, where trouble melts like lemon drops, high above the chimney top, that's where you'll find me, somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly. And the dream that you dare to, oh why can't I? Someday I'll wish upon a star, wake up where the clouds are far behind me, where troubles melt like lemon drops, high above the chimney top, that's where you'll find me, somewhere over the rainbow, way up high. And the dream that you dare to, oh, why can't Thank you for listening to that song. It's a beautiful song. I know Izzy Israel, and he passed away a few years back, made that a famous song from Hawaii he was from. And then you also know the other person who sang it that was famous, more famous than Israel, was Judy Garland. And she sang the song in The Wizard of Oz, Somewhere Over the Rainbow. And I'm going to sing that one too in another video. I love to sing, and I just keep singing, just keep dancing, just keep having fun. Thank you for watching my video. Thank you for liking and subscribing to my YouTube channel, and just for enjoying your life too. Every day, every second of your life, have a good time. Do as much as you can. Have fun. Whatever your hobbies are, your travels, your bucket list, just do them. Life's short, but we're going to be in eternity as a Christian in the presence of God, of course. But right now, we have what we have, so we can't even imagine heaven. We can read about it, we can think about it, we can wonder about it, we can think we know, but until you're there, the sorrow you have here is nothing compared to the joy, which you're like saying the complete opposite of sorrow, but the joy is going to be so great. It's going to be. And that's what the Bible says, and I believe the Bible's the truth. But Judy Garland, she was in The Wizard of Oz and other movies, danced that Easter Parade song, and in the other one about the World's Fair, not New York, I was going to say New York, St. Louis, me in St. Louis, whatever the song is, I can't think of it. But Judy Garland was famous, had money, and I'm going to say it, up the wazoo. Excuse me for saying that, but I've heard that so many times as a kid, people saying that. And they told me to live right and live by the Bible, yet I saw so much sin in my life because people are people, like I said otherwise too, that Adam blamed Eve and Eve blamed Satan. And We all blame someone else that we couldn't have been the one that done that's done something so bad, you know? So meet me in St. Louis, Louis. Meet me at the fair, the World's Fair. Judy Garland, a dancer, singer, the most beautiful voice. She was an alcoholic who died because of all her addictions to alcohol and taking prescription drugs to keep going as the great movie star and actor and singer and dancer that she was. Her life, was a mess. We have to look forward to eternity with Jesus. And somewhere over the rainbow, I think, is like heaven. Not where you find a leprechaun or a pot of gold or whatever they say. And the rainbow is God's. He created a rainbow to say in a promise to us that he will never flood the whole earth again because of Sodom and Gomorrah and the sin going. Well, that came later with the fire and brimstone, but because of sin, not Sodom and Gomorrah, excuse me. I'm human and I made a mistake. Because of the sin going on, he asked Noah and his sons. And Noah built the ark. And that was Noah, his wife, his two sons. Noah and his wife was three sons, I'm sorry. See? You don't get everything perfect, but excuse me, it's three sons. Ham, Shem, and Japheth, I think. Don't take my word on that. Look, read the Bible and find out. But anyways, Noah, his wife, and three sons, and they had three wives, so that was eight people. So he saved them we all come from them. And there was the Tower of Babel. Read the Bible, it all adds up and makes sense. And the Bible's about our pitifulness, that we need Jesus. And he used our pitifulness, people that were bad and did bad, for good. Because Paul himself was Saul before, not King Saul, but Saul in the New Testament. Came Paul and wrote a lot of books in the Bible to the Christians. Then there's Peter. There's Hebrews and the Israelites. And then I can't even think of the word. It's just left my mind. Get behind me, Satan, because I can't remember the word. The Gentiles. Paul was there to preach to the Gentiles and Peter. That it's all by grace now. We don't have to sacrifice doves or oxen or a lamb or all that. Jesus is the sacrifice for us to be able to spend eternity with him. And that's what I believe. So, I just hope you're having a wonderful day, that you keep singing, dancing, making music, and having a good time.